Greetings, everyone. This is Fleet Admiral Alt Lexington of the Merrickie Command Federation Fleet. It's Wednesday, the 16th of March, 2016, about 9:30 in the morning. And I thought I'd start this video off here in our starbase. Yes, this will be a rather lengthy video, I suspect, because it's going to be a ship building video. A new ship to add to my collection, but we'll get to that in a minute. As you can see, our starbase has some nice decorations. We're only a level 14 fleet, a small fleet of role players from another game called Second Life, who have expanded into Star Trek Online for a bit of extra fun. Those mannequins over there are our latest addition to the starbase, with all the different uniforms on them. Yep, the Fleet Admiral finally found a place to hang his old elite armour, his old Mako armour. Nice little fish tank there. If we just have a look at the fleet page, you can see we are a level 14 fleet. Look at the roster. We haven't many people in our fleet, but we're coming along quite well. And I just want to go into holdings right now and just to make a little donation to the fleet. One of our aesthetic projects that we like to do. It'll only take 2 hours for that project to complete. I like to do them from time to time because it costs a bit much for fleet members to be donating that much dilithium, and since I'm in a position where I can, that's what I do from time to time. That project will add tables and chairs to the area up here. Make the starbase look a little better. The next one I'm going to queue up is to open up this area to show the inner workings of the starbase. Anyway, ship build video. Let's get on with it, shall we? I wonder what ship we're going to build. Just beam out of our little tier 1 starbase that's surprisingly well provisioned at the moment. Wow, this has taken a while to load. I hope it's not going to be one of those 20 minute loading sessions. There we go. Oh, and what's this? That's a familiar looking ship. Yep, it's called the USS Fearless, and it is the original ship in my line of ships. If we look here, it's completely overpowered for what it is. Oh, and that's not an EPS one, I haven't afforded that yet, I've just got a flow one. Conductive RCS. If it had EPS instead of flow on it, it would be the best console in game at the moment. Or at least one of the very best. But the reason it's called Fearless is because if we look at my list of ships, you can see Fearless A, Fearless B, Fearless C, Fearless D, Fearless G. So, Most of my main ships are called Fearless. And my latest one, the Fearless X, let's have a look at that. And for some reason, the Mako visuals have come back on every now and then. I don't like that. I like the shield, I just don't like the visuals. Yep, this is one of those new Tier 6 operations Star Cruisers from the bundle of 9 ships which I got. I called it the Fearless X because I had Fearless and then Fearless A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and it got a bit silly, so I went straight to X on this one. But this isn't the ship we're here to talk about. Even though we can have a look at its stats, which are pretty cool. It's a 24k ship at best. 24k DPS. Which some of you are saying is pretty pants, but considering most people get stuck around 15k, that's pretty good for me. Especially since I only run off a level 14 fleet, a small fleet. And I'm more interested in the actual gameplay than the chasing DPS. Anyway, let's make our way to the Sol system. I can transwarp there to make it quicker. Because this isn't the new ship that we're talking about either. We're going to have to go to a ship requisitions person for this, I believe, if I'm right, but I'm not sure I'm right. So we're heading to the Sol system so we can board Earth Space Dock. Ooh, a lot of players around at the moment. Now some warp plasma there by the looks of things. Head into dock at the station. Earth Space Dock. The orbital part of Starfleet headquarters. The academy being the ground part. Excuse the low resolution of this video and a bit of lag here and there. I'm getting a new computer next week, but this one will have to suffice for now. For those of you that haven't seen Earth Space Dock, let's just pan about a moment so you can see the magnitude of this place. Let's turn chat off a bit. For some reason, just lately, chat has been very busy. Let's open up my inventory to see what ship we're going to be unpacking today. Here it is. I'll give you a hint. It's from the Terran lockboxes. I bet you've guessed what it is now. Yep, special requisition pack. Folian Tarantula Dreadnought Cruiser Tier 6. Wow, did I feel lucky when I got this. This package contains One Folian Tarantula Dreadnought Tier 6. Unpack the item to receive your ship. Well, let me tell you something. I've been playing this game for over 3 years now, and I'm a very dedicated player. I'm online a lot. And I've opened up a few lockboxes in my time, and I've never received a ship in all those 3 years. So when the Terran lockboxes came out, and there was talk of this Tarantula, and everybody was talking about it more than any other ship from any other lockbox, I decided I was determined to open a lot of Terran lockboxes. But I wasn't after the ship, though. I was after Lobby crystals to get the Lobby store consoles. And I wasn't getting any ships anyway, because I didn't expect to, since I hadn't in the past. And then yesterday, for some strange reason, I opened up no more boxes than I normally open, but I got a Mesh Weaver, a Folian Mesh Weaver, and I was thrilled to bits. But then a few hours later, I got another one. And then a few hours after that, I got my Tarantula. And then a couple of minutes after getting a Tarantula, I got a third Folian Mesh Weaver. And I still haven't had a chance to use the event ship that recently happened, the Kremen Science Vessel, or even unpack it. So how's that for freaky luck? 3 years of opening lockboxes and nothing, and then one day, four ships in a row. Including the ship everyone wants. These mesh weavers are currently going for around 3 million on the exchange, and the tarantula is going for about 320 million. But I'm not selling it, I want to use it, so let's open it. Unable to. There we go, I've got. Haven't got any space for the new ship, so what I'm going to have to do is dry dock a ship. Haven't got any more ship slots, so I'm going to have to go to a ship selections officer, which is this guy, and dry dock something. Hang on a minute, I'm getting a bit of lag here. So let's dry dock something I don't often use. Something a bit old and rubbishy. Got anything old and what I would call rubbishy. Ah, there we go, the Fearless A can be dry docked. The upgraded constitution. That gives me one active ship slot. So now I can open this. Folian Tarantula Dreadnought. What should I call it? Cool. Look at that hull. That's not bad for an unmodified, unused hull. Four weapon slots, four device slots, one hangar bay. I'm gonna have to skimp on a hangar bay ship because I haven't got anything good. I don't often use pets. Well, I thought about calling it the USS Tox Utat, but I'm not exactly sure how to spell it, and it will cost me if maybe it will tell me from an episode how to the correct spelling. Spelling of Toxic Mutat. No. Besides, I bet everybody's called theirs the Toxic Tat. So I'm going to call it. Continuing my line of ships, and since I've already done Phyllis X, this will have to be. This morning for typing. Dyslexia. So annoying. Fearless God. That's a bit much, isn't it? Toxutat. It'd be embarrassing if I've spelled it wrong, wouldn't it? Just hail one of those episodes to see if it says anything. Ah, there we are. Tox Ufat. Uvat. That's how you spell it. That's what I'm going to call it. And I bet it won't let me because somebody else has already called it that. So it's Tox dash Uvat. Just double check. You've had, yeah. Was allowed to name it. I'm surprised they let me name it that, because sometimes when you type in a name you can't use it because it's already something in game called that, or rude words can't be used. But there you go, Toxotat. That's exactly what I wanted to call it. Give us the Toxotat. That is all. So now to decorate the ship. Or should we ready it first? Hang on a minute. I think we already did, didn't we? No, we didn't, so... We need to ready the ship in order to decorate it. We've already... Requisitioned it. We've named it. Now we've got to ready it for use. And look what it comes with. Tetrion weapons. And what is that? Fermionic torpedo. That could be interesting to use. And as you can see, it levels with you all the way up to Mark 12. If you wanted to go further than that, you'd probably have to upgrade it. And a console. Universal Folion Web Cannon. Now that will be awesome. That's what everybody in game wants this ship for, because you can throw a Pholian web around an enemy and crush them. I believe. We'll have a closer look at the console later. And hangar pits are the Pholian Widow Fighters. I'm glad it came with hangar pits because I don't currently have any good ones on this character. Anyway, decoration time. Which is the blue guy. Customize your ship. Customize starship. Now we go into the starship window. The tailor shop for starships. Ooh, that looks good. Something straight out of sci-fi. Much more than the normal starships are. Trouble is, the lighting in here isn't very good to help decoration. Oh, and look at the bridge. It's one of those hexagon bridges. And obviously you don't have any choice of layout or additional bridge because it's with the standard Pholian set. And you don't have any windows, instead you just have a web. And the material, Pholian type 1 or upgrade. Well, let's turn it so we can see it a bit better. Pholian type 1 or upgrade. Let's have a look at upgrade a bit closer. It looks interesting, but it might compromise other colours. Well, we'll leave it on Pholian type 1 at the moment. Where we see what the options for colouring are. Shall we go with a green or an orange? We'll start with an orange, I think. And then look for patterns on the hull. Ooh, look at that, straight away. That's good. Virgo is interesting, but I kind of like Corvus. Web generator. I suppose that's this big circular thing. Yes, it is. So we go left on view. Little turn, zoom in as much as possible. Cygnus is the only one that gives it any real colour. That's the colours on the back. It's hard to tell where the pattern is. Especially when it keeps moving. Orion. Or Virgo. Let's see what Orion looks like on the rest of the ship so we can make it uniform. No, I don't like that, Corvus. It doesn't have to be red. I just used that as a base color. First one is for the interior, I think, isn't it? Yeah, so the interior. If we make the interior parts of the ship green and the exterior parts blue. Gives it a kind of evil inside. We have a look. I'm just going to check these to see if the pattern makes much of a difference. No, we'll stick with Corvus. Okay, that's my look. Purchase it, it will automatically save, and it costs zero to purchase. In fact, everything is zero on this ship, you don't have to pay for any of it. Now walk away from this guy for a moment. So that we can choose our officers. Well, I've got some standard officers that I use. I don't go for those fancy officers. But let's see what station's got. Lieutenant Universal Intelligence Station. Lieutenant Commander Tactical. Commander Engineering Station, because I'm an engineer, I suppose. Or is it standard on the ship? I'm not sure. Ensign Universal Station. and science station. Oh, for the engineer. We'll put in my android. Tier 4 ability, auxiliary power to structural integrity. Emergency power to weapons. Emergency power to shields. And engineering team. This station, Ensign Universal Station. The question is, do I want it to be a tactical or a science? Well, since this is a Universal Station, that can be the second tactical, so this can be a second engineer. And as a second engineer, put on my first officer. And we'll give her a battery, I think. Direct some emergency power to auxiliary, but then with the build I'm going for, I'll probably have a lot of auxiliary anyway. So I may not need that. So I think I'm going to go for another emergency power to weapons. Instead, I could always change it later. For tactical, well, it's going to be fire at will. So who do I normally put in for fire at will? See what this officer has. She's a pilot. So in here we want fire at will 3. She doesn't seem to have the fire at will ability. So I'm going to have to go with another officer because she can't even learn it, I don't think. Beam array fire at will 3. In this slot, maybe a tech pen beta or torpedoes, I think torpedoes. And in this slot, either fire at will, we'll go tac team 1. Here. Well, it loads each ability. And science team. Somebody told me to go with my hierarchy guy. Because the hierarchy guys have better abilities, but he's an intelligence officer, so he would go into that slot, but since I want another tactical in there, I'm going to have to make do with somebody else here. She has gravity well, so that's good. And the number one slot can be science team for the shield enhancements. And this one is going to be the difficult one to figure out. I don't really have anything that would enhance science abilities because I'm an engineer and I haven't really stacked anything on there. So it's really dealer's choice on this one. I wonder if there's anything that would enhance weapons. These are all debuffs on a science. Plus 24.3 all damage resistance, not damage. Not straight damage. Recharge time reduction to bridge officer abilities, that is interesting. Minus weapons and power. Hazard emitters for running against Borg. It's 11 incoming energy damage back to target for 10 seconds. I'm just going to go for straightforward hazard emitters. This won't be the final build anyway. I'm going to leave my traits as they are. Accurate. Astrophysicist. Beam barrage. Warp theorist, operative, innoculous, beam training, grace under fire, thrill seeker. Space reputation, advanced targeting system. Enhanced shield penetration, precision, enhanced armor penetration, an active space, active reputation, biomolecular shield generator. I can never stay still long enough to benefit from that, but it's still useful to have. Quantum singularity manipulation. Usually forget to use that. Refracting Tetrion Cascade. That would be good on this ship since it is a Tetrion weaponed ship. Not that I'm going to put Tetrion weapons on it because I haven't got any good ones, but one day if I do, that would be good with it. Deploy Sensor Interference Platform. Now I might change that one out for something else. Space abilities? No, I haven't, so I can't change it. And starship traits. Well, I won't have my tarantula trait yet because I haven't done any mastery on it. So I'm going to stick with enhanced power condensers. Adaptive hull plating, improved pedal to the metal, improved predictive algorithms. Now this one I might remove because this one came with the Operations Cruiser, the Tier 6 Operations Cruiser. So I think I might remove it. Plus 3 maximum hull hit points. I think it was that one that came with it. Or was it this one? Improved pedal to the metal. So I'm going to remove that one for now and put in something else. All hands on deck. Recharge science bridge officer abilities. But I don't do much science. All that will do is enhance my science team for a shield buff. And captain abilities. Oh, that's good. Demolition teams. Delayed kinetic damage aura. I think that works with the Omega set. Energy siphon for plasmonic leech if I'm going to use it. Now we're going to take out improved predictive algorithms, I think. No, accuracy buff and weapons buff. Weapon synergy for torpedoes. Well, I only have a plasma torpedo from the Omega set, so I'm not really bothered about using that. Greedy emits power drain minus weapon cost after using energy siphon, tachyon beam or Tycon's rift. Yeah, what does it work with plasmonic leech? Attack patterns gain a hull healing buff to self. Well, I've already got attack pattern data for that. Structure integrity overcast. I think I might put something in for shields. Increased accuracy for weapons buffs. Ah, no, I'll leave it there. So that's the bridge officer. Skills done. Now for the crew, the duty officers. Well, they didn't change from my last ship and they proved good enough for me. A technician for recharge times reductions, that makes, and there's two of them, so that makes the fire wheel work quicker. That reduces the cooldown on fire wheel, I believe, although I could be wrong because I'm not that knowledgeable about the game. Improve ship power and use of emergency power abilities. Well, that works with emergency power to auxiliary or something, or is it auxiliary power to, I don't know, but I know it's good, it works for me. Recharge time reduced for engineering team buff, that's good. Applies a turn rate debuff with tachyon beam. Well, I'm not using tachyon beam right now. I've gone for gravity well and hazard emitters. So let's see. chance of temporarily improving your ship power on use of an emergency power ability, chance to immobilize enemies when you... I'm looking for something that enhances hazard emitters. Good, because I do have directed energy modulation. However, he's just a common. Chance to create aftershock after gravity well. Since I'm using gravity well, that might be good, and it is a purple. So yeah, we're swapping him with him. So now I've got all purples. That's the best I can do with what I've got at the moment. The next step is to remove the junk that comes with the ship, these Tetrion weapons. I might buy some Tetrion weapons and make a Tetrion build at some point, because Tetrion weapons are pretty cool. Well, cool looking. And this thing, Fermionic Torpedo, that would need upgrading, but we'll take it off for the moment, because I'm not sure I'm going to actually use it. It depends what its details are. Later, I just want to get into space first, and to do that, I'm going to be putting on some of my space equipment, like the I'm not going Iconium, because I'm not convinced Iconium is better than Adapted Mako. And Adapted Mako is my trusty set, I've used it for a long time. Fleet plasma warp cores plus free damage free subsystem. I've got the Iconian warp core, but what's been working for me is this plasma integrated warp core, and it's not a fleet or an Iconian one. And the reason it works is because it has plus 100 increase to base power regeneration rate of all power levels. The other ones don't have that. That's why it seems better to me. Could be wrong. I'm not an expert ship builder. I'm just a casual player. So now we've got our engines on. Let's beam to space and fly away from the rabble. Fly away from the crowd and see what we can do to build this thing. First look. Well, I don't see its pattern all that clearly. I wonder if Transwarp has cooled down so we can get to the starbase. Yes, we have. Fleet starbase system. Maiden flight, straight to our starbase. suspect that the reason I'm not seeing the visuals all that well, the paint job, is because we have to disable the shield visuals. There we go. That's much better. Much better. Yep. You just right click on the shield, go down to visuals, disable or enable. And I disabled the Mako visuals because they ruin the ship's paint job. And also this cracking on the hull, I'm not keen on that. I prefer smooth, so I might go and change that later. Might go back to the ship tailor later and change that. Oh, I like the green effect on the back. I never noticed that before. Some more effect shows up over time. I like the green inside, especially with that Mako, adapted Mako deflector. It really is a monster looking ship. It's a pity they haven't made it so that these claws on the front here can open up like in the James Bond movie Moonraker, I think it is. They should open up and swallow other ships like pincers. Let's do the loadout, and it's pretty obvious what we're going to do with the weapons. Anti-proton, but not the Iconium ones. Advanced fleet anti-protons. A little word of advice for Mirky viewers from my fleet. Our fleet may not be very advanced. And you may not actually be able to buy these weapons from our fleet stores at the moment, but our fleet stores are provisioned. So, and you can use those provisions from our fleet to get a map invite to someone else's fleet and buy from their stores using our provisions, but only on your fleet character. So if you want to a map invite to someone else's fleet, your own fleet has to have provisions in order to buy from their fleet, and then you can buy stuff that your fleet doesn't have but does have provisions. So if your fleet can't sell these weapons but it has provisions for weapons, then you can go to someone else's fleet and get them. And normally there's a lot of people, big fleets out there who want to help out smaller fleets by allowing them map invites. There's loads of them. I get whatever I want whenever I want it. Big fleets are very proud to help out smaller fleets. All the smaller fleet has to do is keep its stores provisioned. Even if they can't sell anything with those provisions, they can be used in other fleets with map invites. I'm not going for the omnidirectional agent, I'm looking for the omnidirectional anti-proton, but not the ancient one. I could have swore I had it on the Fearless. On the Fearless X. Anyway, I put the cutting beam here, I suppose. Kinetic cutting beam. Ah, yes, the ancient anti-proton beam isn't as powerful as a standard fleet anti-proton beam array. And in here, I can either put the Mako Plasma Torpedo or this new Folion thing. Well, let's pull the Plasma Torpedo out of the Fearless X. The Omega Plasma Torpedo. Then put it into inventory. Put it next to that and then check. Folion Fermionic Torpedo, 2295 DPS. Plus 20 accuracy, plus 10 accuracy, and 4% critical chance. Doesn't say what its DPS is though. Although Folion one does look better, but it will need eventual upgrading. Let's have a look at the info. Fermionic torpedoes were scavenged from captured Folion vessels and have been adapted for use on most modern starships. Although these projectiles deal less damage than most other torpedoes, they are also capable of draining the target's weapon and engine subsystems with each hit, reducing their damage output and speed temporarily. You may only equip one of these. This weapon stops improving when you reach level 50. Use the tech upgrades to improve this weapon beyond that level. I think I will, but not right now, not during this video. Torpedoes are high damage things, yes, we know all that, but the 20% accuracy seems pretty good, but I suppose it only applies to that particular weapon, so I'm just going with my standard Mako for now. This, the Folion Web Cannon, plus 12 kinetic damage resistance, plus 11 all energy damage resistance, plus 3.3 maximum hull capacity, area of effect extreme physical damage hold after 6 seconds of charging. Folion Web Cannon affects up to 10 foes in a 90 degree arc in front of your starship. To foe it deals 4747.2 physical damage, ignores shields. To foe it deals 2533.1 physical damage every 0.5 seconds for 12 seconds, ignores shields. To foe holds target for 4.8 seconds. That is an awesome console, but I don't want it in my tactical slot, because in my tactical slot I'm going to want two of them and one of them. These for the anti-proton damage and critical chance, and that for the critical severity boost. In my science slot, improves shield energy drain. These are fleet from an embassy. Sure, you get the ones with flow and decreased threat generation by 75%. We put two of them on there for now. Improved shield energy drain. Here we're going to want our trusty Borg console, although I'm not convinced it's that brilliant. Let's put that down there for now. In here, Where's that awesome console? There it is. That console gives you a hell of a boost. Tachyokinetic converter, 12.5 critical severity. And we put in leech. Although that might be good. But let's try leech first. Yeah. Subspace field modulator, temporal negotiator. Weapons battery. Shield battery. Yes, these consoles, the bioneural infusion circuits from the Lobby store gives you 25% critical severity and helps with your ship hit points. Awesome console that is. Everybody should get that from the Lobby store for 200 Lobby crystals. Tachyokinetic gives you flight turn rate, which helps on a big, huge ship, a dreadnought, but a massive severity boost as well. Plasmonic leech, I'm not sure that's good anymore. Apparently, there are a couple of traits that give you just as much. However, and they're going to nerf it eventually, so. And I've never been convinced it's that good anyway. You have to have the right skills as well to get it to work. So let's have a look at the stats. Now that I've done this, power transfer rate 339. Well, my operations cruiser had more than that. It was up to 419. Major hull strength, and that's without any mastery. Shielding resists the pants, but look at that, 25, 15, 127. That is awesome. And not a bad flight turn rate either. Yep, all of those at 99, except for stealth and cloaking, which I don't need. Shield drain and energy drain could be better, but shield healing is good, resists are good, knock and repair is better than I would expect. Not that I'd got any skills in that. Hold and disable is pretty crap, which you might need that with a web. But hull healing is okay. Ship hit points is through the roof. Power transfer rate. I could do with a bit better power transfer rate, to be honest. Let me think, how did I do this before? It might be time to take out that. You get 11.5 severity from it, and my severity is quite good. So if I take that out, my severity goes down. Have I got something with more severity? Something better? Severity. That's critical chance. Sticky web. Well, there's no point in putting two of those webby consoles on there. Bounty Hunter's Friend. Plus 28.1 all energy damage resistance. Improved shield drain and energy drain. 50% fluid turn rate. Reduces damage to shields, 20% turn rate. There's nothing that will do any better than that Borg console. Although that would improve my shield drain and give me a lot more turn rate and flight speed, which I suspect I might need on a ship like this, but that means sacrificing that. Let's just look what it does to my resist and power needs. Hasn't done much for my power. However, look what it's done for shield drain. Take it out, and it goes down to 105. And 105 is pretty good, so if we take that out and put Leech in there, and then put this in there, and then we can put the board console back in. So now we've got shield drain at 105, which is okay. Not the best, but our severity is back up again. However, we can afford to ditch some accuracy. In favour of more severity. I could have swore I had another one of these somewhere. Obviously not. But I swore I had another one of these spire consoles, vulnerability exploiters. Because they had 9.4 critical severity. But anti-proton damage. Only you can only see it when it actually fires. I suppose, because it improves all weapon damage. Team turn rate's got even better. It's because of this. So my shield drain and energy drain isn't that good. But everything else is good except for resists. Must never forget to do that. But before we do that, let's go to the trace skills. Sticky web doesn't add anything great. Resist, shield drain, and energy drain. I think I'll stick with the build the way it is, but I'm gonna have to sort out the traits, the skill tree now. Afford to sacrifice a little bit of accuracy in favour of severity. So I might actually buy one of them. Just clearing out my tray so I can arrange these the way I want them arranged rather than randomly. Now we can put them in my way, which is fire at will first, followed by torpedoes, followed by emergency power to weapons. Where is it? Emergency power to weapons 3. Did I even stack emergency power to weapons 3 on this ship? Yes, I know it's there somewhere. There it is, I went right past it. Folian web cannon. Let's put that somewhere where we'll remember to use it. Temporal negotiator, tactical team, I'm putting them where I'm used to having them. Subspace field modulator, that's awesome, that is. It adds whole hit points, but it also partially cloaks your ship, but you can still fire while partially cloaked. It's the oh crap, they're gonna kill me button. You hit that whenever you feel that the need. Whenever you think you're gonna die and all your abilities, all your other abilities aren't there, you hit that. It's oh crap, they're gonna kill me and I've got no abilities. Wham! Hit that and you'll survive. Rotate shield frequencies. I didn't slot that, but I've got it. It must be an engineer ability. Rock and roll, that's a good one. Whenever the crystal entity fires its huge weapon, it does it twice during an entity match. Join crystalline entity match. It fires twice, and whenever it fires, you've got to hit this button, and you won't take any damage no matter how close you are. Survive the crystal entity. Miracle worker. Grace under fire trait makes this work much better. Lone wolf. Not exactly sure what it does. Plus 50% defense. Hazard emitters. Gravity well. Fleet support. I'm just going through them randomly, finding ones I recognise and putting them where I think they should, where I'd normally put them. There is something I'm missing that I should have slotted. Now that I'm thinking about it. Let's go back to this. Let's have a look on here. Power to structural integrity. I was hoping to put something a little better there. But here. We give engineering team there. And here we change that to vanity power to shields. And then this one can become auxiliary battery. That's more like it. Because auxiliary battery, plus 31 weapons power, plus 31 shield power, plus 31 engine power. I wonder, can she learn the battery power in her fourth slot? Yes, she can. I'm going to have to get that for that slot. Because it's a lot better. Anyway, let's go back to this. Energy power to shield 1 isn't really sufficient. I'm going to have to do some skill retraining. I usually put these. Put that there for now. Attack pattern beta usually goes up here. Let's switch your gravity well because I like it there. Molecular shield is always useful. Brace for impact. Oh, where'd that come from? A sensor platform. I didn't know I had that on any of my officers, and I didn't know it was. Oh, it's from a trait, isn't it? Basic maneuvers always important. Where's emergency powder weapons 1? We've already got that one loaded. And we just removed emergency powder weapons 1, so we won't have that. options. Mask energy signature. Well, if we move that down there, we can put mask energy signature up there where I'm used to it. Nimbus Pirate. Although this, this, and this are on shared cooldown, all three of them. There is a trait that will speed up this cooldown for these, so that if you hit Delta Recruits, then this one will come out, then this one will go in down into cooldown as well, but it will come out of cooldown before Delta Recruit is finished, so you can hit it. So we'll get double the fleet recruits in. Okay, there's only one more that can go here, and I suppose it will have to be that. Not that I'd have it, that I use it that much. And the only reason I'm putting it there is because I've got no other space for anything. So up on bar 4, just to be obsessive compulsive, we're putting our anti-proton weapons. Cutting beam. And our Omega Plasma Torpedo. And then ramming not ramming speed, we go for full impulse and quantum slipstream. This would be a lengthy video. Then in here I usually like to put my shield resists in. One day I'll get around to making macro keys for these abilities that I won't have access to in battle, without having to hit the little tiny arrow buttons. I'll have to come up to key binding them. Now, if I switch that up to there, I can then put in that sensor platform thing that I didn't realise I had. Give that a try. I think that's from the Iconian resistance trait. Reputation. Just remembered my weapons aren't arranged correctly, so 2, 3, that's 5, so switch that to there. 4, 5, 6, and switch that to there. Make sure it's auto-firing, that's good. 5 stacks of weapon proficiency, of weapon synergy. I believe that's what it means, but I don't know for sure. It means the next time I fire it'll be pretty damn good. Not that I've got any torpedo skills. Now it's time to just chuck on everything that I haven't chucked on so far. Now that might be better than sensor platform. I think I mistook the subspace field modulator for this. So if I take that out from there and put that one in quantum singularity manipulation. I don't know how that would work though, because I don't have a quantum singularity on this ship. So why would I work with a warp core? Mustn't forget to use that one. Now we lock that. Nope. Now we lock the tray. And my powers are set to attack. Push that up as high as it will go. See what the numbers are. 125, 85, 45, 25, 20, 36. That's a lot of auxiliary power there. Suppose we can change that for shield power. That's much better looking. And that way we can monitor the power flows in battle. God, this is tiring. Not that I'm complaining. Oh, look at that. Lexi Lex Lexington. She's an android. She'd a wife. Skinny Malink. I've got Pilot as my primary maxed out, primary specialization, and Intelligence as my secondary maxed out. But I don't usually use them. I should look into about using them a bit more. Now, my resists are absolutely awful. I'll probably replace this for some spire swarmers or something like that. My shields aren't great. My hull strength is brilliant. My shields aren't great, and neither are my resists. And neither is my shield draining ability. Now that helps to drain shields by the same amount as that. But this gives a plasma based proc, whereas that gives turn rate and increased power, is it? We'll take that off for a moment and see what it does to the power levels. Nothing. My turn rate if I take it off. But my turn rate's not that bad anyway, it didn't lose much. Now my shield drain's gone right down. But if I put, say, Leech up there, put in more resists with this one that is power insulators instead of that one's modifier is flow, which improves shield drain, whereas this one's modifier is ins, which is power insulators resists as shield drain. But it hasn't done anything to specific resists. Has done something there. Let's take it out again. But then 99's not so bad. What I really need is something that will improve my and I've just realised what I'm missing. Structural integrity. I know I've got it. There it is. I slotted it for a reason. Now, one of these has got to go in favour of structural integrity. Thinking that or that. Let's switch that out, move that to there, move that across to there, and put in structural integrity. Since I can't use Nimbus at the same time, that can go up there. Lotus Pirates are more for healing you, whereas Delta Reinforcements are more for helping you attack. Well, at least that's how I see it. But I'll never say that I'm right. So we can put Nimbus. We take those two out. This is just me being obsessive compulsive for the moment. Let's see what that would do for my resists. Ooh, still not that good. And it's a shared cooldown with that. What does that do to my power? Nothing. Really should increase that. But then I lowered my auxiliary power here. Only for 10 seconds. And it has a shared cooldown with that, so I might remove structural integrity. But I've got nothing to replace it with at the moment. Modulation 3 would be a good one. Auxiliary power to inertial dampers. Ah, reverse shield polarity, that might be the one. Anyway, I can iron out these details later. Happy with my resists, not happy at all. Ah, would help if I put a console in there. must be a console with all kinds of resist on it. All energy damage resistance 28.1. That might be good. Let's see what this does. Yeah, that's better. I'm gonna have to upgrade that. Now what happens when I hit that? 45, even better. And that's cooldown has speeded up. And I don't think that's going to be much use to me, to be honest. Shield drains are right down though. Why is my shield strength so low? Maybe it's to do with traits. Starship traits. Let's see if we can find some resists. Or something to do with auxiliary. We can sacrifice a little bit of accuracy for resists, I think. That's accuracy. So we can sacrifice traits can only be activated and deactivated while in a social zone. So we're going to have to go back to Earth Space Dock to change that. I thought your fleet area was a social zone, but what are we going to change it to? Let's make sure let's go back to Earth Space Dock now. Solar system. Second flight of the Tox UTAT. So now what we do is we change the trait. We sacrifice a little precision for anything that gives us good resistances. chance to inflict area effect damage trigger. Phaser and control phaser damage and control resistance. Torpedo destructible using plasma, using shield healing bridge officers also reduces minus shield penetration. Increased max hull. Auxiliary power gives defensive buff. All energy damage resistance. But that's on hitting a auxiliary power thing. Plus 10 all damage bonus resistance rating. I don't think it's a case of these traits. So what one did I have in there before? I can't remember what I had in there. I'm going to put it back in. That's the one. So let's see if we can change some of these for resistances. Plus 10 plasma, that would help against Borg. But is there an all energy damage resist? I fine with 35 because it looks better now. Yes, I don't like that gun so very much. I do like the shield draining of that one. How's that? 96 shield drain. Power transfer has gone way down. Gone way up. 414. That's much better. My shield drain isn't that great. My resists are still pretty pants. My resist might not be that great, but I might not need so many resists with such good hull. So the battery doesn't do anything really that spectacular. Shield resists do, but they're still not that spectacular. Anyway, let's beam to left space dock. Can retrain a few skills, and at the same time, check the decorations. Retrain a few breach officer skills and check the decorations. So decorations first. See if I can get rid of those cracks on the hull. Was good the way it was. You can't get better than can't get a smooth hull on this ship. So now it's bridge officer training. My bridge officers, they aren't the fancy ones. the ones I had got when I first joined the game, and I just stuck with them because I got attached to them. Now, bridge officer training, we're probably going to have to go to the exchange for this actually. Well, you already know that doesn't do much, so what can we replace that with? Powder shields 2 on there, and then this one we can put in another fire, put in engineering team, and here exchange. See if we can buy a manual to replace this with something good. Directed energy modulation 3 might be better here. Or reverse shield polarity. Thinking directed energy 3. It's not a resist, but it'd be more beneficial than the panzer resists I've been getting. That'll probably be more beneficial. Ah, hazard emitters. Hit points. All energy damage resistance. But that might have been what I've been overlooking. Let's have a look at my own skills. Not that I can afford to respec, because I did that last night before I got this ship. I didn't realise I was getting a ship. Which one provides resistance? To be honest, with these skills, I should have quite a bit of resistance. I don't understand why I don't. But then, Maybe the reason I don't is because the ship can't generate many resistances due to having such a powerful hull. I'm getting a fair old bit of lag at the moment because I'm recording. But let's fly out of the way here. Oh, it's not a very good ship to steer. I'd like to be able to look in front of it and see my enemy. This thing certainly doesn't stop on a dime. So is this. Now hang on, I've got to move some of these around again. A ship with such few resists. That's what's bothering me. But with a huge hull, I may not need them. Anyway, at some point, you just gotta say, enough is enough, and get into a game. I don't like the way you can't move officers around in your inventory. Attack pattern beta do. Not a lot. To be better honest, I should really have that there. It's the battery I wanted to remove. I'm going to have to spam that button a lot in battle. So I think if that is the case, I'm going to swap it with Sticky Web. If I'm going to be hitting that button a lot, I wonder what it does if you combine it with hazard emitters. Ah, there we go. That does it. I may not need such a power transfer rate because it's pretty good as it is, 300. So all I should do is put a leech back in there and put this back on. Turn rate as well as me energy drain, or I could not put that back on, but remove that. Come on, put leech back in there. Insulators. No, I'm not thinking right. That was the way to go. Yeah, I think that's the way to go. It may not be as good as 400, but at least my shield drain is back up, and so is my flight turn rate. So I think we've done it. I think we've got it there. Now, as for what goes here, something's gone missing. I don't remember what I had there. Oh yes, that folio console, I just moved it around, which made it come off the tray. There it is. Sticky web. Not sticky web, web cannon. Sticky web is something else. Make sure it hasn't slotted on any of this automatically. I do tend to do that. I think I finally settled on the build. So now all that matters is to make a build slot. Standard. And saved both of them. standard for something for my initial build, and unstandard for experimenting to try and improve on the initial build. So, everything looks good. I don't really like having the hangar bay here, because I've got access to it down here, and it just gets in the way. But let's launch one of those pets just to see what it does. There's the little thing. There's another one a bit closer there. Let's launch a few more. Another one there. Interesting. They're lining up to protect me. I always forget to launch my pets in battle. Let's recall them. Now, I wonder what Sticky Web would do. Yeah. Holy crap! Wow! What the hell is that? My god. Once every 2 minutes. My god. Say for the maiden battle, the proper maiden flight. I'd probably die in this or piss off a lot of people for using this ship I'm not used to, but who cares? I want to give it a try in ISA. I won't pass it because I'm recording video, and if I try and pass at the same time I'll probably crash the video, the whole game, so just hope someone else will. Not that it'll be that good. Now, must remember, hit that and that. Structural integrity and hazard emitters on a regular basis. Just wait for this cooldown to finish. Because you never know, we might be able to get the big cube in. In a web. Although I am going to have to eventually seek advice on this build, because what I've been doing hasn't been working that well. And I don't see it getting any better with the skills and stuff that I have. The skills and gear and officers that I have. So, join ISA and then wait forever for it to start. But I'm so happy I got a Folian Tarantula. Chat back on in case the people in game want to abuse me for messing up their match. It's always risky taking your a new ship into ISA, but it's the only real place you can get a good handle on its abilities. because that's where you normally pass your ships. There we go. That didn't take too long. Now let me embarrass myself by blowing up on my maiden voyage. My first battle. Unless the hull strength proves good. Probably crash anyway since I'm recording. Whoops, never hit that straight off where you go so slow you won't be. Yes, I am lagging a lot, I apologize for that. Being a bit careful and a bit cautious. You will lower your ships and prepare to board. I have the ball. Please don't let me blow up my first time. So close to blowing up several times. they're just sticking with the big cube. And I'm dead. My first trip out, I died, but I did pretty well to survive considering how weak I was getting. I really am going to have to retrain for this one. Well, why aren't my pets launching it? I think it's because I'm half asleep. Seconds for sticky web. Let's not try. Question. I better dip pants. See if anyone passed it. They did, and I got 13k. Okay, that's pretty poor for me. But then I have been having to press every button 3 or 4 times on my resistor pants. I'm really going to have to do something about that. And the awards are disappearing before I even have a chance to pick them up. Somebody posted the pass and 13k DPS, that's pretty poor for me. I remember when I used to think that was good. Back during the days of the T5 Fleet Escort. I was getting 8 and 9k back then and I thought, 13, that's good. Now I'm thinking 13 is below par, half what it should be. Especially with this ship, I feel like this ship's been given to the wrong person. It should have been given to somebody with much better skills than me. Much better ship skilling builds than me, but I'll improve it over time. That's the trouble. I'm gonna have to completely respec to make this ship anything better than the piss poor 13k. Plus, I died. So she wasn't stellar. The USS Phyllis God wasn't stellar on her maiden voyage, but she managed to get the cube. The big tactical cube in her cannon twice, in her web cannon twice. But I suppose that is exotic damage, so I need to improve my exotic damage skills to get that to work better, or change it to a full Tetrion build. My anti-protons aren't putting out any better than usual. Maybe I should have hit that. Did I hit that when we went into battle? I don't remember, but I'm going to close out the video with a quick patrol. Let's take her into a patrol mission against some Romulans. This could be fatal. Oh, there's a red alert going. You never know, maybe I'll get lucky. Let's try that. Maximum warp to where the Borg are located. Let's try a red alert. Let's be stupid. Unless, of course, the game crashes. Let's go fight the pickle. Or the Vija. And the pickle's already there. Wow. And here I am, just in the nick of time. So, where's me cannon? Here we go, fire!
Resistance detected. Your mission 0047. 4 of 10. Engage now.
Right, the pickle! Need some energy sources with that pickle! There she goes, blown to pieces. And I'm gonna blow up on the way out. Yep. I hope those energy sources went well with that energy pickle. Dip the energy pickle in energy source. Goodbye, Vija. Oh, nice pictures opportunity there. Screenshot opportunity. Now, where's the option to leave map? Fight the pickle! That was just a mission of opportunity. Now let's go fight some Romulans like I was planning to. I was going to take this ship into Crystal Advanced, but not today. I've changed my mind. It's not well built enough for that. So we're going to go to a patrol. The Kareya system. The Kareya system, if I pronounced that right. That's always very good for patrol. I mean, my tier 6 scimitar just nukes that thing. Each fleet that comes at you, it nukes them in seconds. My T6 scimitar takes down a Dideridex warbird in 3 seconds flat. Without taking any damage. Whereas this thing will probably be crushed by it, by the Dideridex. I wonder what quantum slipstream drive looks like around this thing. T6 texture always flashes when you zoom in like that. It's like the game doesn't like you getting too close and taking too good of photos. Here we are in Kayana's system. Karaya system, whatever they call it. So let's target the Dideridics first off. Come on, target the Dideridics. I'm asking you to target it for a reason. Because I want to sticky web it. Sticky web. I keep saying sticky web when it's actually... Here we go. There we go. Oh, it got both of them! I got the Mogai as well! And the Dideridix is down! Mince me. Now this is more fun than those advanced matches. Because you actually get to win in these. Rock and roll. There is a slight delay factor between when I press a turning button and the turn actually happens. Hit on the gravity well and nuke the bastards. Die, die. Sula, you getting the message yet? Drops to pick up. A lot of vendor junk. That's what makes this patrol pretty good. You get plenty of vendor junk. Even launch any fighters. But that was even much better. I mean, a 13k ship takes them down so quickly. I'm surprised by that. I mean, it didn't do that well in ISA. And it wasn't because of the team, because the team were doing pretty well. It was because of my build. Lacking oomph. Or maybe it didn't lack oomph, but maybe it lacked survivability and being killed is what decreased my DPS, but I don't think it's that somehow. I think the build is wrong. However, it did completely the opposite in this patrol. It did much better than I expected. After its performance in ISA, I thought it would do pretty bad here, but it didn't. It did okay. need to sort that animation out, unless that's my internet connection. Maybe we should try another patrol just to see. But this ship is clearly not ready for advanced matches. So far I'm not seeing why everybody is so eager to get this, however, I'm not giving up on it because it's more than likely my build that's wrong due to lack of resists. In fact, embarrassingly low resists. So here's the Japuri system. Let's get in there. I'm not going to do that red alert because it's probably Folians. I don't want to go up against them just now. So enter Japuri. Let's see who we're fighting this time. Looks like Norsetans. Ship. Here comes the web. That makes me out of that ship. The web is good. I can confirm that much at least. The web cannon is awesome. Just alone to that web cannon. This ship would work better as a silencer than an engineer or a tech or anything. Junk to pick up. I don't know why I bother picking up this junk, because I use real money in the game, I don't grind. Game loses its fun element if you grind too much. didn't try a fleet alert. Okay, I think we'll call that the end. So let's go back to where we began. Or let's go to the Dyson Sphere. Because there's a few things I want to show fleet members. And also, this gives us a nice daylight view to see the latest ship in game. The latest ship that everybody's after. Print screen, I'll take some pictures. Take some pictures for the Second Life Sci-Fi Fair. This should get them recruited. So Docker Aspire. So fleet members, this is our Spire. Tier 1 Spire, but what you may not know is that I recently completed a few projects, aesthetic projects, to make it look better. For example, we have another room here now. Conference room with a Spire leader's desk. But that's not the best. We also have the ability if you watch those these big pincer things on the ceiling, yep, activate or deactivate the orrery or however you pronounce it, from these two consoles down here. Makes it look much nicer and brighter in here. But that's not all. Recently did another one where you can open balcony doors. So you can go out onto the balcony, but you can't skydive down or jump into that lake down there. But at least you can get out into what looks like a nice frosty morning. As you can see, the other side of the sphere up above us, with all its cities and towers, that's probably where the Boff live, or the Undyne. Spire is a much more happening place to hang out. Beam to ship. warp's on cooldown, so I'm going to have to go back to our starbase to end the video where we started it. Via normal travelling. So as you can see, Meriki Command isn't led by one of those big DPS gods like all the other fleets are led by. It's led by just a normal person, just like you, if you're not a DPS god. So you should feel comfortable if you want to join our fleet. No pressure to hit hard while we're travelling to the starbase. I'll just show that the Spire's next project will be to open up the command area behind with the extendable curving ramps and the Omega molecule. I also want to show that our research lab is 10 hours away from becoming Tier 1. I mean, all the projects have been completed, have been filled, now we're just waiting 10 hours for the last one to complete. Sorry, second to last one. This is the last one is this one. And I've got everything I need to fill that straight away. So after this 10 hours, that is up, the upgrade project will start, and that will take 5 days, but I've got everything we need to fill that straight away. In fact, I'll be filling it up today, probably. Everything except the fleet marks, but I have a way of getting them. There are people who are kind enough to donate those sort of things, so they can get fleet credits. Starbase dock. So we can end the video where we began it, and lo and behold, look what's happened. There's a change all of a sudden. We now have tables and chairs and ship shelves decorations. Remember that project that I did at the beginning of this video? It now completed. And this is the result. A nice conference area, proving this video is over 2 hours long. So, since this video has reached the 2 hour point, the well over 2 hour point, I suspect, I'll give you one last look at my failed build, although you can't see its stats here, and the mastery has got up to not very far along. Remember, it was zero mastery when we started. physical damage over time. Hold on beam. Overload cannon, rapid fire, or surgical strike. That's the trait that comes with the ship. Energy web. Maybe the ship's resist will improve as I increase my mastery. I never thought of that. All energy damage resistance, plus 25. Yes, it will improve. No wonder. Plus 25 all damage, all energy damage resistance. That is going to be awesome. And here's me worrying about my damage resists. Because they are what got me killed in ISA. Critical chance. More hull, as if I need any more. So I hope this video was useful to you, or at very least enjoyable and not too boring of me sleepily grinding my way through it. But at least you can say that Meraki Command is one of the first fleets to put out a video of a tarantula, the ship that everyone wants. This is Fleet Admiral Ord Lexington of Meraki Command saying enjoy your gaming and bye.